ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देव महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परम ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। We saw last week, अनेक चित्त विभ्रांता मोह जाल समावृताः प्रसक्ता काम भोगेषु पतन्ति नरकेषु च। In the 16th, we are in Jnaneshwari, that is Bhagavad Gita by Jnaneshwar Maharaj, chapter 16, verse number 17, and we are recapping the 16th verse, and it says, bewildered by many such fancies, caught in a web of delusion and addicted to sensual enjoyments, they fall into foul hell. And so they live in an imaginary world, they live in a make-believe world, and thinking about it again and again, I wish I can be there, I'm going to become this, I'm going to do that, I'm going to own this, I'm going to be a millionaire by 30 years old, I'm going to see many. When we were young, a fantastic young boy who was in IIT, which was just behind our house, about half a kilometer away, third year IIT, just because he did not get the marks that he wanted, he committed suicide because he came second or third instead of first. So what is that? In your own mind you are imagining that I am the best. And when that vision of your own self is broken in your own mind by the circumstances outside, it is very difficult to handle. And thus they create a web, a jal, a net within their mind of, and what is this net made up of? Thoughts, wrong conclusions, wrong ideas, likes and dislikes, emotions which are not helpful for us to remain equanimous, and thus this person gets caught up, and that caught up person is called a husband, that caught up person is called a wife, that caught up person is called a son or a brother or whatever, because he has or she has accepted all those thoughts to be real. The one who becomes miserable is the husband or the wife or the brother or the sister or the daughter or the son. Man or woman, don't get disturbed in that example. Mind never gets disturbed. Mind keeps pumping up thoughts. Senses do not get disturbed. They are continuously illuminating their area. Then who is getting disturbed? This person who is imagining, who is thinking that these imaginations are his, these thoughts are his, these emotions are his, and without these thoughts, without these emotions, without these conclusions that he has aspired for in life, I am a nobody. And in this way, they get addicted. I think in the last class I told you about the difference between what is addiction. We think that objects in the world space, time, and objectivity, these are the ones which are giving us joy. But the joy, when our desire is fulfilled, when we become quiet, mind becomes quiet because the desire is fulfilled, we think that joy, that bliss that we experienced for that moment was because of the particular object. And this way we have programmed ourselves that the joys that we are experiencing is only because of the outside world. So the wife gives me joy, the husband gives me joy, the food gives me joy, if this happens it gives me joy, if I come back to my own house then I am joyful, if I sleep in my bed then I am at peace, when I get the chapati made in a particular way then I am happy, if the dosa is soft and not crisp then I am happy, or the vice versa. And it goes on, and this is how we program ourselves day in and day out. And this what happens? And once I start experiencing the bliss or the joy from the objects, then I want to interact with that object, interact with that experience, interact with that place, interact with that person again and again, so that I can experience the joy again and again. And very soon, it doesn't take too long, that you can't live without that object or that person. This is what is called alcoholism and drugism. They all begin with one peg, and then one bottle is also not enough. Same way druggies, take little bit. First time they will not like it, but then after effect, while taking it they don't like. But afterwards, the mind is clear. Mind is in a high. Now they want it again, then they want it again, and before you know, they are addicted to it. This is addiction. So just blaming these people who are alcohol addicts or drug addicts, no. We are also addicts. Husband is an addict, wife is an addict, son is an addict. Husband is the addicted to wife. Wife is addicted to husband. We are addicted to food, we are addicted to good music, we are addicted to so many different things without which we cannot live, if that is the case. But if we are someone who, it's okay, everything is okay. But here it is told, and addicted to several enjoyments, they fall into foul hell. Then they lose the plot. The mind is deluded and they lose the plot of life. And until unless they are not cleaned, what is that? They are sent to detox retreats, alcohol detox, drug detox, then they become normal, or they start getting the hang. Oh, this is how I used to be. Because they themselves are tired of taking that particular drug or alcohol. Unless we do not become tired of this world. Outside we must perform 100%. But inside we must have vairagya. Vairagya is you are tired of this world. Because kutte ki poonch tedi hai aur tedi rahegi. This world is like this. It can never be improved. First World War happened, Second World War happened, the Third World War also will come someday, we don't know when. If you look in the last, at this particular moment, no country is at peace. Everywhere something is going on. Even before coronavirus started, in every country atrocities are going on, hunger is there. They can spend so much money now because of coronavirus, But when people were there and they were dying of hunger, that time they could not spend the money to increase their status of living. Now, where is the money coming from? Hundreds and hundreds of billions of dollars. Every country is doing that. So from where it is coming? Why couldn't they bring that out at the time when everything was normal? So in general, this whole world, it's cyclical. It's going on. And once it clicks to us that, hey man, aise hi hai. Aise hi hai. Yesterday I had $500,000 in my superannuation, and when the market was down, you must have seen your superannuation must have gone down to 300, 350. Oh my God, what will happen? How will I live this, that? All options coming in your mind. What can I do? What can I do? Whoever is yours today may not be there tomorrow. Whatever you like today, you may not like it afterwards. Ask the diabetes people. They used to love sugar. Now they can't. And they have trained themselves. I don't like sugar. I don't want sugar. Ask those cholesterol people who eat paranthas. Now, parantha, I don't like it anymore. Then we used to eat 10-10 parathe kha jate the. Ab kya ho gaya? Nahi yaar, cholesterol ho gaya. I trained myself not to like it. Now I can't handle it. Before I used to enjoy smoking. Now I can't handle if someone is smoking. Kya ho gaya? What happened to you? Nahi yaar, I stopped smoking. Now even passive smoking, it disturbs me. See? Similarly, whatever you are liking now and thinking that it is the norm, it may not be there in the future. So are we going to go through the highs and lows as dictated by time, space and objectivity, possessions and relations, or are we going to be equanimous? Those who are not equanimous, those who are addicted to the world, they are the asuras. And they fall into, here he says, they fall into naraka. And thus these people, they are ready to do whatever. They are ready to destroy the world to satisfy their desires one way or the other. And last week we also told that such people, they organize concerts, they invite Mahatmas, they invite musicians, they organize big, big shows. Why? I did it. I was the sponsor. In that brochure, it will be sponsored by so and so. And then the puja is done. Yeah. And then for the puja, they will charge $300 per person. And it becomes a business. That's what it has become. Organizing lectures in India, there was Asaram Bapu, who is in behind bars now. 200,000 people used to come and listen to him. But he will go to any place only if he is given 25 lakhs. That was his demand. And there are others who demand even more. There are others who are demanding even more. But these big businessmen, baniyas, they think they are doing a great thing, you know, and then the whole society...
Alert from. Updates ready to install.
They think that because they are sponsoring, they have made the money by wrong means and they are or good means, but they feel that they are using it for the right purpose. But all it is for the name and fame, and they become pratishthit. These are the varishta persons of our society. Why? Because you know they sponsored this Mahatma, and you know how much he charges when he comes. Oh, the more the price, the more channels he is coming on, the greater he is. See how foolish we have become and get caught up in this whole drama. Now with that, in the next, so this is what these type of people do, and this is like a very stark example our Jnaneshwar Maharaj gave. Pari vifalita acharoniya nataki jaisi, meaning just like a prostitute who lives under the protection of her lover and remains contented, pretending to be a loyal wife. This is our state. We are prostitutes. You, me, every one of us. Because we are not satisfied with the self. Just like a prostitute wants different men all the time. Same way, we want something to see, something to hear, something to interact, something, relationships. We are not happy with ourselves. We have outsourced our happiness to the objects and beings. But we look down upon her, but ourselves behaving like that. You may not like it, but think coolly without taking it personally. That is what we are. And on the facade, oh, I am a dharmatma, I am a seeker, I am a great lecturer, I am a great ritualist, I am a great speaker. So many are there. But in the back, they are doing all this. Taking advantage of innocent people. That listen to Ram Rahim, Asaram Bapu, Swami Nityananda from Bangalore. All snakes. They take advantage of the innocent minds. They trust. They have faith. And when you become, because common man thinks, this is the foolishness, because the common man thinks, instead of going after the divinity within himself, he thinks divinity is in that person. And then he becomes person oriented rather than divinity oriented. He becomes form oriented rather than self oriented. And then any person who is form oriented, hey guru, aapke bina kuch nahi hota, hum to aapke bachche hain, humara take care of us, this, that, and that Mahatma then takes you perfectly. He understands because he has done a little bit of sadhana. He knows. He has got the acumen. He says, bakra mil gaya, kaato. Matlab, those who don't understand Hindi, English, Hindi. Now, I got a sacrificial lamb. Now I'm going to use this fellow any way I want to. Ocha, dekho, get that done for me, please. Get that done for me, please. Get that done for me, please. He'll use and use and use and use and use you. And God has brought you together. Why? Because you think he is God. He is not God. Form is not God. The one who is expressing through the form is God. And when you get to that, then you will realize that the form, not only that form, every form is God. See how we shortchange ourselves. So God has brought this stupid fellow and that con man come together to pull the wool off this ignorant fellow. आफ्टर वन एक्सपीरियंस, टू एक्सपीरियंस, थ्री एक्सपीरियंस, इवेंचुअली ही रियलाइजेस कि यार इट्स बेटर नॉट टू रन आफ्टर दीज फेलोज बिकॉज आई एम नाउ बैंकरप्ट. And this you will come across many people among your community people or your friends who have gone through this experience. Maybe you have gone through this experience also. We go from God to God or from God man to God man. Respecting and revering a God man, a realized master, is a different thing. But to be obsessed by the form of the that person, and in the name of that, to please him, oh, ये दो, वो दो, ये करो, वो करो, इसका कोई अंत नहीं है. So here he says in the 17th verse, आत्मसंभाविता स्तब्धा. आत्मसंभाविता स्तब्धा धनमानमदान्विताः धनमानमदान्विताः यजन्ते नाम यज्ञैस्ते यजन्ते नाम यज्ञैस्ते दम्भेनाविधिपूर्वकम् दम्भेना विधिपूर्वकम् आत्मसंभाविता स्तब्धा धनमानमदान्विताः विताः यजन्ते नाम यज्ञैस्ते दम्भेनाविधिपूर्वकम्. ही सेज इन द 17th वर्स, सेल्फ ग्लोरिफाइंग एंड स्टबन, ड्रंक विद वेल्थ एंड प्राइड, दे ऑफर सेक्रीफाइसेस इन नेम ओनली, ऑस्टेंटेशियसली नॉट कन्फॉर्मिंग टू स्क्रिप्चुअल इंजंक्शंस. So who are these? आत्मसंभाविता स्तब्धा. स्तब्धा इज स्टब्बन. आत्मसंभाविता दोज हु आर सेल्फ ग्लोरिफाइंग, दे आर ग्रेट इन देयर ओन आईज, रेस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड इज कंडेमिंग देम. यू नो अ प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ सम कंट्री राइट नाउ, सेल्फ ग्लोरिफाइंग, I did this, I did that, I got this, I got that, and the whole world is booing him. Have we become like that? Where we believe the children have grown because of me, wife is happy because of me, success is because of me, wealth is because of me, friends are because of me, so many people I have helped because of me. Are we great in our own minds? Self-confidence is different. This is self-glorification. Our estimate of ourselves is greater. The one who is really thinking that the self is great, he will not say anything. But this fellow goes and advertises everywhere. You know, I got him that job. You know, I got him that car. You know, I did this. You know, I did that. You know, I sponsor so many children for World Vision. You know, I have got an orphanage back in India. And in the name of that, keep collecting money. Keep collecting money. All charities in Australia are in big trouble right now. Nobody is giving money. We are doing such great work in Africa. We are doing such great work in India or some other third world country. For them, these are third world countries. But in that name, in the name of misery of other people, what they do? They extract money out of you. According to Australian law, 13 cents they spend on the cause, 87 cents they spend on themselves and their lifestyle. Every charity in Australia, In America, it is only 9 cents by law you have to spend on the cause. There was a TV program when the tsunami came in Aceh. That time, $370 million were collected by World Vision. Only $50 million were spent by World Vision on the cause. What did they do with the rest of the money? They built a huge center on the corner of Burwood Highway and Springville Road. And they employed more people to do cold calling for more donations. And they increased their salary from 150 to 300, 400,000, the top people. Asuric pravritti. Are we becoming like that in our small, small interactions with the world, where we see in everything what is in it for me? What is there any gain? Only then I will get involved. If there is no gain, I'm not interested. And in our own eyes, we are greater than the greatest. So, with this, and drunk with wealth, and for them, success means only the more the wealth, more, that means you are successful. The more the wealth, that is your measurement of success. And because of that, we get attracted to those who have siddhis. We don't get attracted to real mahatmas. Because our interaction with the outer world is like that. Where there is wealth, we give respect to that person. Then we realize that wealthy person is also at the mercy of this fellow with the siddhis. So we go to that wealthy person now with the siddhis. And you can see that in the world. People with siddhis, they will have many followers. But true mahatmas, very few followers. Sometimes they are incognito. You won't even know that they are mahatmas. They offer sacrifices in name only, and they do not conform to the scriptural injunctions. So let's see what Jnaneshwar Maharaj says. Taise apanaya apana manita mahantapana fugati asadharana garvetene magalavo nenati kaise ativa lohace khamba jaise ka udhavale akashe shadarashi taise apuliye barave apanachi rizhata jive trunahi huni aghave maniti nicha. Then beating kettle drum, in this way they put on airs of greatness and become puffed up with pride because they got the money, they got the moolah, they have the capacity to see. Why did that Sushant Singh Rajput, what did he say? That these big production houses, there is nepotism there. Because they have the money, they have the clout, they have the power. So they are able to make someone's life and they are able to break someone's life. See? Gundas, this is Gunda Raj. With people with such mentality. Are the Rakshasas. Then they remain rigid like a cast iron pillar on a rock rising up high in the sky, living in the comfort of luxury. Three people. You know who I'm talking about. In the family, only three people. Living in an 18-story house in Bombay with a helipad and a 15th floor garden with 100 cars in the basement. Three people. Then who is the house for? For the servants. 45 servants. And for them, I have made it. I can fleece the money out of other people. I have got new tricks up my sleeve. And they will do it all legally also. They will bend the rules wherever, and they know they can get out of it. And they become stubborn. My way is the my way. On the strength of their riches, they look down upon others as if they are blades of grass, trunamatra. Trunamatra, that, you are nothing. I can make you, as I said before, I can make you or I break you. Don't mess with me. And when you push a person too far in that direction, now everyone in Bollywood is coming out, that what these production houses are, how many lives they have destroyed, already 3-4 suicides, and now for last 10, 15, 20 years, all the new people who have, no new people in the Bollywood, who's coming up? Only the children of the already established people, only their kids are coming up. But new people are not allowed. They gave them one movie, two movie, then they destroy their career. As if it becomes their own fiefdom. All working for each other. Not for the common good. Their common is only these 10-15 families. That's all. And that's what we are also doing. Don't blame them. We make the wealth. Whom do we share it with? We share it with only our family members. With our parents, with our children, with our cousins, we help them. We help this. Someone who is known to us, we help. Have we gone out of the way and helped anyone who is whom you don't know? There are so many. Someone came to Swamiji one day. He said, Swamiji, I'm retiring. He came specially from Dubai to meet Swamiji. He said, Bolo Maharaj. He said, Swamiji, I'm retiring and I'm going to resign. Not retire, resign. Maybe retire. And there were many offers to him for consultation and all that. He said, Swamiji, I don't want to do all that. I have done enough 30, 40 years. Now I want to do spiritual work. Tell me, Swamiji, how can I help you? Swamiji, I don't have anything. I don't have anything. No hospitals, no schools, no universities, no ashrams. No, there must be something. He says, Swamiji told him, go back, get a job, you're good at it, make more money. But now you don't work for yourself, you work for me. Know that whatever you are earning, you have to give it to Swamiji. Don't give it to me. Then what do you do? No, then you go around, find people from middle class families who are just making ends meet. There are intelligent children there who don't get the chance to go and study and get into the courses that they have to get into because of the money constraints. Or they don't get the tuition, but they're smart. Go and help them. And he started doing that. See? But we are only in our own box, in our own clique. Jnaneshwar Maharaj continues, Vari dhana chiya madira, mazuni dhanurdhara, krutya krutya vichara, से सवते केले जया आंगी आयती ऐसी तेथ यज्ञाची गोठी कायसी तरी काय काय पिसी न करीती गा म्हणौनी कोणे एके वेळे मौढ मध्याचेनी बळे या गाची ही टवाळे आदरिती ना कुंड मंडप वेदी ना उचित साधन समृद्धि आनीतयासी तव अविधि द्वंद्वची सदा देवा ब्राह्मणाचे नीनावे आडवारे नही नोहावे ऐसे आथी तेथ यावे लागे कवणा पैवा सरुवाचा भोकसा गाई पुढे ठेवूनी जैसा उगाणा घेती क्षीर रसा बुद्धिवंत. आय चॅन्टेड वन एक्स्ट्रा टिल 385th वर्स. ही सेज moreover, intoxicated with the pride of wealth, they dismiss from their minds all thoughts of what is proper or improper, because paisa balwan hai, money is power. And then all wrong things become normal. Think, in your lifetime, why your our lifetime, I'm talking just till 1981 or 82, 83 also, maybe 86 or till 86, there was no official stock exchange in India, government recognized. And that time, to put money in the shares was called dalali. And it was looked up. People who deal in such dalali, buying and selling of shares, they were called gamblers and they were looked down upon by the society. And we used to tell our children, don't become a student of that person, or don't have too much friendship with that fellow. He's a gambler. But today you see, share market, buying and selling of shares has become the norm. Every retired person is dealing in buying and selling of shares. Why? No, yaar, time pass hota hai, and then I don't get dementia because of it. Bekuf. So that has become the norm now. See how, within how many, 30, 40 years, within 40 years, that which was supposed to be the ill in the society has become the most esteemed thing in the society. This is what money does. This is what power does. And if those who are rich, if they are not living dharmically, righteously, and who are not living righteously, these rakshasas, how to make 1 cent into 10 cents and 10 cents into 1 rupee, 1 rupee into 100 rupees, 100 rupees into 1,000 rupees, this is only the thing in their mind. They go for holidays, they don't look for enjoyment. इधर ऑल्सो अच्छा चलो लंच करने के लिए जाते हैं. लंच करने गए, अरे यार ये रेस्टोरेंट तो बहुत अच्छा चल रहा है. ही मस्ट बी मेकिंग अगेन, ही स्टार्ट्स कैलकुलेटिंग हाउ मच मनी दिस फेलो. माय गॉड, 70 टेबल्स एंड बिफोर आई फिनिश्ड माय लंच हाफ द रेस्टोरेंट वाज टर्न्ड ओवर अगेन. सो मच मनी इज मेकिंग, आई थिंक आई शुड ऑल्सो पुट वन रेस्टोरेंट हियर. ओनली थिंकिंग अबाउट मनी 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 मनी. They dismiss from their minds all thought of what is proper and improper. This is what companies, big corporations, what are they? Private venture funds and hedge funds, what are they doing? Or venture capitalists, what are they doing? Investment bankers, what are they doing? They take a poor company, break it up and then sell it. They don't care about people. They care about how much money they are going to make out of it, without adding any value to society. Without adding any value to society. And that goes into their heads. See, when such things accumulate and crowd in their minds, how could they be expected to perform sacrifices as prescribed? Then they do yajnas so that they get more wealth. They will meet Mahatmas so that they can get the position in the parliament. They get elected. They remember the Mahatmas only when the elections are coming. Rest of the time nobody goes. You also go to God only when you have got some big project. Then the prayer is ardent. Other times you may go. But theek hai. Maybe it's out of habit. But the real prayer comes when there is difficulty in your life, or there is something that you want to achieve and you have already invested so much of your time and money and resources. That time the real prayer comes. Because the losses can be humongous. So the prayer is also directly proportional to the expected losses or investment made. Other times no investment. चलो जाके आते हैं. क्यों? वहाँ पे यार वो रेस्टोरेंट बहुत अच्छा है शिवा विष्णु टेम्पल में. वहाँ पे डोसा अच्छा बनता है. सो यू डोंट गो फॉर गॉड, यू गो फॉर दैट. देन आई डोंट हैव टू मेक फूड एट होम, यू नो. टुडे इज अ ब्रेक, देन वॉट आर यू डूइंग? गोइंग टू टेम्पल. अच्छा, यू वॉन्ट अ ब्रेक, दैट्स वाई यू आर गोइंग टू टेम्पल. यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू टेम्पल फॉर गॉड, फॉर योर पीस ऑफ माइंड. सी हाउ कॉन्वोल्यूटेड अवर माइंड इज. And this you must have heard. Maybe you have talked in this manner, or you have heard other people talking in this manner. When such things accumulate, when such type of thoughts, where money is king, then when thinking becomes like that in their minds, how could they be expected to perform sacrifices as prescribed? You go to Haridwar, you go to Varanasi, you go to Badrinath, you go to Trayambakeshwar, you go to any place, Tirth Stan. If you see those pandits standing in front of you who are doing the puja, they have got no tej, there is no purity about them. Neither in their looks, neither on their face. एक सात्विक आदमी का जो disposition होता है वो आपको मिलता नहीं वहां पे. But because they are pandits, you can't do it yourself. If you can do it. Some mantra they will take and dar 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 dar, they will speak so fast you don't even know what they have said. बस आखिर में स्वाहा और समर्पयामी. Oh, you think they have chanted the mantra. Bekoo banaya. Such are the hypocrites. And they want 500, 1,000, 2,000. And in the night you go and see their lifestyle. I'm not saying all of them are like that. But the numbers are increasing day by day. And see their lifestyle. The same pandits drinking, vyasan, living an unrighteous life. Perform sacrifices as prescribed. But one cannot be sure as to what such half-crazy persons will do. Like some president in today's times, you never know what statement he will make tomorrow. I love this country. Tomorrow he say, I'll hate this country. You never know what he's going to say. Realized masters are also like that. You can never work out what they're going to say. So, crazy person is also like that. What this person is capable of. So better not mess with these people, these asura people. As to what such half crazy persons will do. Sometimes in a frenzy of foolishness, they are ready to perform a sacrifice sanctimoniously without any purity, without any scriptural injunction. See? Why? I have the money. I will do it whenever I am. I don't believe this. I don't believe that. I don't believe the Vedas. I don't believe. No, I want this. To some extent, this is how Arya Samaj came about. Arya Samaj, that Swami Dayananda, when he was young, he saw that prasad was being offered to the statue of God, Krishna. And young child, he saw that the mouse used to come and eat away the milk, drink away the milk, or the monkeys will come and take away the prasad. And he started thinking, what is this God who can't even take care of his own prasad? Murti upasana is pagalpanti. And he became totally anti-form. And that's why he established Arya Samaj. So a person, so he has understood the Vedas incomplete. Our Vedas cater to formless, formless with attribute, formless that divinity with form and with attributes, and it even caters to that one who is a non-believer also, who does not believe the nihilist philosophy. To that also we believe, we cater. Vedas are complete. But in the name, and then you create your own religion, your own sect, that we are this, we are that. For what? Because one whim, one fancy. I'm not saying he was a crazy person or anything, because I don't know what person he was. But this is how things happen. In the end, he is a Vedic person. He is a Hindu person. So, but one cannot be sure as to what such half crazy person will do. Sometimes in a frenzy of foolishness, they are ready to perform a sacrifice sanctimoniously. For this, they do not need a sacrificial pit, nor a pavilion, nor an altar, nor the materials necessary for a sacrifice, and they are ever opposed to scriptural injunctions. They don't want to perform it according to the way it is given in the scriptures. Then swaha karna hai to kya karna hai? I'll give you one simple example. Asuric way. I don't know I am right or wrong in this one, but that's the thought coming to me right now. Write all your bad, all your shortcomings, all your fears on a piece of paper. Light a fire and offer that piece of paper in that fire, and believe that as the fire is burning those, it is your fears and your shortcomings are also burning away. Do it. No om, no gana naam tva, no invocation of the agni devata, because by doing the proper way, we format our mind in a particular way. See, this is the Asuri way. This is an example. I don't know if it is the correct example or not, but that is what is coming to me right now. I have even seen people Why say that? Only that example. I have seen people who do not know the mantra of Sandhya Vandan, but they know what the sequence is. They get up in the morning, they will light the fire and do some shortcut, pat 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 pat, and some om 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 om, something they will do because they don't know the whole mantra. And then what are you doing? Oh, I did Sandhya Vandan. They cannot bear to hear the names of deities and Brahmin priests wafted on their ears by a breeze. Such people, if you talk to them about God, if you talk to them about scriptures, if you tell them some mantras, they are like, touch me not. They run away, they become angry, they are ready to kill you, ready to hurt you. Just like Aurangzeb was one sect in the Sunni sect, they are absolutely against music. Sufis, they follow music. But Aurangzeb was belonging to a sect which is totally against music. He said music is haram. And anyone caught singing, anyone caught playing any instrument, they used to kill him in those days. Literally kill him. That much hatred for music. Similarly, there are people who are absolutely opposed to the mantras, to the Vedic chants, to the scriptures, to the... See, now you go to India today, you go to Maharashtra, anti-Brahmin. You go to Tamil Nadu, anti-Brahmin. Karnataka, it's getting there. Kerala, forget it. Communist. So those who are educated, those who are scripturally oriented, we have created. Now that is fault of the politicians also, no doubt. I'm not going to go into all that. But today's mentality, you see, an educated person cannot get a government job in Maharashtra or Tamil Nadu. Impossible. It is only reserved for others. So what do these fellows do? They come to Australia, go to Canada, go to America. Because they are seekers of knowledge by nature. Whether it is the world knowledge of the world or internal knowledge, but only a mind, a Brahmanical mind, means a creative mind, a learned mind. And I'm not talking that only by birth. Maybe this was also required, because today in society we have made it by birth. The son of the Brahmin may be a biggest crook. Like if you go to all these tirth places, the son of the Brahmin is the next priest. But he may be a big crook. But we have to accept him. He is the son of the priest, so he is the next priest in line. Maybe this anti-Brahminism was required to break this mindset that a Brahmin son is a Brahmin, a Kshatriya son is a Kshatriya, a business person son is a Brahmin, is a business person, Vaishya, and a Shudra son is a Shudra. This has to break. It is not so in our scriptures. A Shudra son can also become a Brahmin by guna and karma. And a Brahmin son can also be called a Shudra if he has the according to his gunas and karmas, he is a lazy fellow and a rakshasi. Then he is not even a shudra, he is worse than the worst. So maybe this whole rediscovery of our culture is happening by nature, is making it happen. They cannot bear to hear the names of deities and Brahmin priests wafted on their ears by a breeze. In such a situation, who will care to attend their sacrifice? Who will go? Yeah, I went to one lady many years ago, 20, 25 years ago. Very established family in Melbourne. And their mother passed away. And they called me, "Swamiji, we want to do a Ganesh Puja at home." And I said, "Okay." I went and did Ganesh Puja. I said, "Are you not doing Shraddha? Shraddha, when a person in your family dies, then you do Shraddha. Shraddha is you remember the soul after 13 days, at the end of 13 days, because it says 13 days is the time it can hang around and eventually it goes away. And that in those 13 days you read the Bhagavat Mahapuran or organize satsangs at home, so that if the soul is hanging around, it listens to the what is the ultimate destination and goes that way rather than remain stuck to the earthly plane." Oh, she says, no, I don't believe all that." I said, "Why did you call me to do Ganesh Puja then if you don't believe that?" No, "There is nothing called ancestors and this and that." "Are you?" "Then what are you going to do?" "No, I'm not going to call any Brahmins. I'm not going to do any Shraddh. Instead, I'll remember her and feed the poor people on the streets." Asuri vritti. This is asuri vritti. Those people who say that all the hundreds and thousands of liters of milk which is poured on the Shivalingas all over the country is waste of milk. It's asuri vritti. They think Shivalinga is not God. But our connotation, our take on that is, no, the form of the God, that statue of the Krishna, that statue of Devi, that Shivalinga, they are nothing but what we are calling them to be. Shivalinga is Sakshat Shiva. Krishna statue is Sakshat Krishna. Devi statue is Sakshat Devi. Ram, Sita, Lakshman, that family with Hanumanji, it's Sakshat, they are there. Why? Because the reality expresses as what? The divinity, what is its nature? Sat, Chit, Anand. What is the first thing? Sat. Sat means existence. So when I'm touching the Shivalinga, when I'm touching the Krishna or the Devi Murti or Ganesha Murti, is it existing? Yes. So I'm touching existence. And to that existence, I have given a form called Ganesha or the Shivalinga or the Ram or Krishna. So when I'm touching a statue, I'm not touching a stone. I'm touching existence. This is the beauty of our culture. But these fellows are against the name and form. See? ऐसे कभी होता है क्या? एंड देयर फॉर यू मस्ट हैव सीन, यू मस्ट इन योर लाइफ, इन अवर लाइफ वी हैव सीन फ्यू फ्यू आई थिंक अ डेकेड अगो वेयर गणेशा ऑल ओवर द प्लैनेट वॉज ड्रिंकिंग मिल्क लाइक इट्स नोबडीज बिजनेस. इन इंडिया, इन इंग्लैंड, इन अमेरिका सब दूध पिला रहे हैं, वो पी रहा है. हाउ कैन अ स्टोन स्टैच्यू ड्रिंक सो मच मिल्क? सी, सो देयर आर मेनी मेनी इंस्टेंसेस लाइक दैट. बट असुराज आर नॉट रेडी टू एक्सेप्ट. देन व्हाट डू दे से? यू नो, देयर इज सम स्ले ऑफ हैंड देयर, समवन हैज डन सम मैजिक देयर. And these are the people who go after Mahatmas, that they are doing magic. It's not so. There may be, there are like, you know, there are tricksters there, but not everyone is not a trickster. Then, where are we? Then in the 386th verse. Pai vas ruvacha bhokasa gai pudhe thevuni jaisa ugana gheti kshira rasa buddhivanta taise yaga cheni nave jagavahuni have nagaviti aghave aheravari ऐशा का ही आपुलिया होमिति जे उजरिया तेने कामिति प्राणिया सर्वनाशु. ही सेज बट जस्ट एज क्लेवर पर्सन शफलिंग स्टफिंग स्टफलिंग स्टफिंग द स्किन ऑफ अ डेड काफ विद राइस स्ट्रॉज एंड कीपिंग इट बिफोर द काउ मिल्क इट सो दे इनवाइट पीपल अंडर द प्रिटेक्स्ट ऑफ अ सैक्रिफाइस in order to exact presents from them. Remember what I told you in the previous verse? They organize yajnas in the name, oh, we are going to organize Ramayana, we are going to organize Mahabharata, we are going to organize Shiva Vivah, we are going to organize Bhagavad Gita lectures. And then give envelopes at the end. Or before the yajna begins, before the puja, the play begins, there is a grand altar and everyone is invited. If you want to take part and get the blessings of the Krishna Leela that is going to be performed. And what is the cost? Oh, only $250. And what will you do? Take the thali, do three times and you have paid. Everything is to make money. Everything is to make money. And it doesn't stop there. Then when it ends, now aarti also one plate. How much aarti? Oh, before it was 250, now it is 500. And you have got sponsorship available. If you want to do more, then the entire event can be sponsored $5,000. Oh, but I can't afford. Okay, then $1,000 is okay. I can't afford $500. They're ready to. They're begging. And this you can see happening everywhere. Not just in Australia. India, Australia, throughout the world it is happening. Some have perfected the art. Christianity has perfected it. They make you feel guilty only if you don't give. Then they call it tithing. 10% of your income must come into the church's account. Yesterday I was reading the news. The churches in Australia are telling the clergies that if those who are working and also working as the in the church, that if you are getting job seeker, please 25-30% of your job seeker give it to the church because church is not getting any people going into the church right now, so there is no money for the church. And how much does the church worth in Australia? $30 billion. $30 billion in the name of God. And how do God men in India live? Phatichar. Two cloth, one langoti, one kamandalu. That's all. He goes begging for food. He considers the sky as the roof. He will sleep anywhere, under the tree, outside a house, in the temple courtyard. Here they are having $30 billion and yet they are demanding money or requesting the clergies to give the money that they are earning from their work. And this, now Indian organizations have also learned from these fellows. So they have also started. So they also say, oh, you know, you can help our temple, you can help our organization to spread the word of Hinduism and do what? Oh, only 10, just commit $30 per month for the temple. Commit 5%. We are not asking 10%, we are better than them. 5%. 2%, okay. There also you can bargain. See what spirituality has come to. In the name of God, what is going on? What is going on in the name of God? Only money, 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 money. And when money is the utmost, money is the most important thing, that person is Rakshasa. That person is an asura, not Rakshasa, asura. This is for understanding the asura inclination, the asura personality. But Swamiji, we can't do anything. You don't become like that. That's all. We can't change the world. We must not become like that. We must not have that type of orientation. We must not have that type of thoughts. But just as clever persons stuffing, just like they keep the a mock calf in front of the cow, then the cow starts milking. Otherwise it's good of no use for the farmer. Milk it, so they invite people under the pretext of a sacrifice in order to exact presents from them. See? Clearly it is written. So they perform sacrifices sometimes to gain prosperity and desire the ruin of other people. So all sacrifices not for God. What is the purpose sacrifices must be performed? I'm asking now. Sacrifices must be performed for what purpose?
Purification of mind.
Correct. Only for one purpose, and that is our mind must become purified. And purified mind is equal to focused mind, is equal to concentrated mind, is equal to single-pointed mind, is equal to expanded mind. And how do you do that? On one hand, you have the form of the fire in front of you. And on other hand, you have the mantra coming out of your mouth, which is the words coming out of our mouth are also due to the element fire. And the samagri that we are using to offer to the fire and feed the fire, that is also having a form, that is also fire. So we become focused. Become expanded. But we don't do it for that purpose. We are doing it for all other purposes except for purification. And desire the ruin of others, and they don't care what happens to others. Just like I told you, those big investment bankers, when they buy small companies, they don't care about the people. They just break it up into different parts and sell it. You look today, you look in Australia where you are living. Take 7-Eleven, take Coles, how many millions of dollars they have underpaid their staff? Look at it. It's happening around you. If not happening to you. Why? That extra $2 that I give, oh, attention is on the money. Attention is not on the person. And in this way, the people with this asuric disposition, one more verse and then we'll come to know what happens to these fellows. Still we are looking at what are their, at what is their behavior. Ahankaram balam darpa, ahankaram balam darpa, kama krodham cha sanshritaha, kamam krodham cha sanshritaha, mamatma paradeheshu, mamatma paradeheshu, pradvishanto bhyasuyakaha, suyakaha, ahankaram balam darpa, kamam krodham cha sanshritaha, mamatma paradeheshu, pradvishanto bhyasuyakaha. In the 18th verse he says, Lord Krishna says, given to egoism, strength, arrogance, passion and wrath, these malicious persons cavil at me in their own and other bodies. This is what Adi Shankaracharya did. Muncha, he told that Chandal in the narrow streets of Varanasi. That means still a remnant of that I am a Brahmin was still there in Shankaracharya. And therefore when that Chandal came with four dogs, he said, Muncha, get away. But we are not Shankaracharya. He learned the lesson straight away. We have reached 16th chapter. I hope we have learned it. That great Chandal, who was none other than Lord Shiva, asked him, who are you saying get away? Are you telling this body to get away? But the material that has gone into making my body and your body is exactly the same. Blood, bone, phlegm, fecal matter, urine, and flesh. Your body is also made up of that, my body is also made up of that. So what are you trying to say, get away? Are you telling the Atma to get away? Atma is all pervasive. How can you tell the Atma to get away? Atma is only one. Immediately Shankaracharya fell at his feet. Even though by his looks he was Chandal, by the looks he reacted to him, Muncha. But he had the presence of mind, fell at his feet, and Lord Shiva revealed himself. Are we moving in our life in this manner? Where someone who is unfortunate as compared to us, who is less rich than us, who is unhealthy than us, and we rub it into him. We look down upon him. We pity that person. Never. You want to go to anyone and interact with anyone, only one thing you have to give, and that is joy. And that is only possible when we see divinity in that person. And to see divinity in the other person, first you have to access the divinity within yourself. Otherwise, you can't even see the divinity in that stone statue in the temple. It's only a ritual that you can perform and come back. See? We only know how to use people. We don't know how to serve people. Service is done only when we see that this world is none other than the divine. Then service will happen. Otherwise, what will happen? Deen abhav are here. You will look down upon them. Then you will have compassion. For having compassion towards another person, it is the predisposition is that he is more unfortunate than me. He is less lucky than me. He is less rich than me. And therefore this deen abhav, that I am greater than him. Therefore you are showing compassion. No, we want empathy, not compassion. Compassion is in one of the verses in Vivek Chodamani or where? In this, it came daya. Daya is the quality of asuras. They must show compassion because by nature they are not compassionate. But we all who are following the scriptures, we are God oriented, we study, do our sadhana, we are we accept the Vedas, we should not show compassion, we must show empathy. Wear the shoes, get into that fellow's shoes and see how he must be feeling. And it is spontaneous. And we don't even have to get into the personality issue, that how he must be feeling. I'm just taking slowly to you to the point where I want you to go. Once we have accessed the divinity within ourselves, Mannatha Shri Jagannatha, the Lord of my heart is the Lord who is expressing through all the hearts. To that Lord, can I show compassion? Or will I serve? I'll serve that person then. And I'm not going to look for people to serve. No, whoever comes in my life. In whichever manner. Serve. And because of that service, I have not become greater. No, it was an opportunity. Thank you, God, for serving you. In whichever manner. Given to egoism, strength, arrogance, passion and wrath, these malicious persons cavil at me in their own and other bodies. So such asuri pravritti people, they are not available to the divinity, to the Lord, who, when he says cavil at me, Bhagwan is saying, and where is he? In their heart. So they are not ready to look at me. Nor are they ready to look at me who is expressing as this whole creation. Then where are we? You and me, where are we? Inside the Lord who is throbbing in our heart. About him also we want to think through thoughts. We don't want to be it. We say be the life. You want to think about life. We say be the self. You want to think about self. And when we say Madatma, Mannatha Shri Jagannatha, that he is the Lord of the whole universe, there also, instead of looking at the spirit out there to look at the glory of the Lord, we are lost in the names and forms. We are lost in attachment to names and forms. When we are lost in names and forms, we are far away from the principle of existence. When we are lost in thoughts, we are far away from the self. We are like that prostitute, wanting to experience the self through every thought, wanting to experience divinity by going to every temple. Without knowing what divinity is. Just form-oriented, form-oriented. No, we exist. We must follow the principle. Form is not a principle. Form is a phenomena. Principle is every form exists. So what is the common and common denominator in every form? The existence aspect. Be focused on that. Contemplate on that when you are going to the temple. No, but we, how beautifully it has been decorated. Oh, today they did not give bath to Lord Shiva. Oh, there was no hot water. So, Ganga chai, Yamuna chai, Godavari, Saraswati, Narmada, Sinuka, Jalai, Sminza, Chhadkav karke, Mantra Snan. We are lost only in that. Look at how beautiful the Balaji Mukut is, you know, the crown. Look at his earrings. Who gave that? Oh, that person gave. You know, this is, every day they put new crown on the head of Balaji. Every day there is a new dress for Balaji. Ah, how divine. Crown is, no doubt, everything is divine. But we are lost in that crown and that gem and that earrings and that the gold that is there. Our attention is only on the ornaments, not on the one behind. Already, ek hi verse ho gaya yaar. Okay, we'll do it till 390. मग पुढा भेरी निशाण लावनी ते दीक्षितपण जगी फोकारिती आण वावो वावो तेव्हा महत्वे तेणे अधमा गर्वा चढे महिमा जैसे लेवे दिधले तमा काजळाचे. He says, then beating big kettle drums and unfurling flags, they show themselves off as initiated sacrificers. But all this is in vain. Similarly, what I was telling. And so, you go to Puri, I think 12 times in a day or 7 times in a day, the flag is changed on the top of the Puri temple. And in every temple, there are certain rules. Morning dress is different, afternoon dress is different, night dress is different. Every sometime the Rath Yatra is taken out. All that is good. We are not against that. That is okay. That is the tradition. But because of doing that, have we become good people? Have we become purified as a result of that activity? It's a ritual. Ritual's purpose is only one, to purify ourselves. Have we become purified? Or they're also while going, hey, get away, don't come this, don't touch this, don't do that. And bossing away. These mean persons become self-conceited by this false greatness. As darkness given a coating of lamp, black becomes more dark. Self-conceited people, they have become great in their own eyes, that we are the upholders of religion, we are the Shankaracharyas. Look at Shankaracharyas today in India, bloody fighting with each other. What Shankaracharya? Where is the divinity? Where is this sadhu, the sadhu bhav that is required in a Shankaracharya? Where is it? The Dwarka Shankaracharya says, I am also the Shankaracharya Badri Badri Mat. The one in the Badri Mat, he says, I am also the Shankaracharya of Dwarka Mat. And court cases are going on. Is this for you what they were? You were made Shankaracharya? And seeing that this is a disputed place, one more person built another ashram in Joshimath and he says, I am the Shankaracharya. Then these both became together and they put a case against him. And drama, the drama continues. See, drama continues. These are the self-conceited people. Because success has come to them, power has come to them, they are controlling people, they have the clout to make or break people. But they don't use that clout to do good to the society, they use that clout to expand their faithdom in the community. Uska dusra shabd hai gunda raj. Asuras are gunda raj. Uska koi English parallel nahi hai. Is there an English parallel to gunda? These mean persons become self-conceited by this false greatness. Hindi mein uske liye ek aur word hai, apne aankh mein mia mithu. In their own eyes, they are great, esteemed, well-respected, a force to be reckoned with. But outside, everyone is thu, 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 they're spitting on them. If you take their name, thu, I know who that is. Someone, see, examples come. Today only someone called me in the morning and they said, Swamiji, do you know about this person? I am listening to this person. I said, you may listen, but what that person is and how that person became what she became, we know the history. I say, bahut, what do you call them? Lot of imposters are there. Even in the sadhu community, many imposters are there. True sadhus are only few. Majority are imposters. Oh my God, Swamiji, if you say that, then we can't go anywhere. Yeah, don't go anywhere. Go within. Go within. If you come to the, if you see the number, when I say imposters, if you consider sannyasi to be this cloth, then you will find many imposters in India. Because true Mahatmas, true sadhus are very few. Everyone else is on the bandwagon of becoming rich. Everyone else is on the bandwagon to have name and fame in this world. And that is asuri pravritti, that is not sattvic pravritti, that is not That is not a thought. That is not a disposition which is going to help you to become steady in abidance in the truth or in samadhi. It's not going to help you. Because this was the question of Arjuna when he started, that yes, I have understood, I have seen that I understand that you are the all that there is, that whole the thing is outside of you, O Lord Krishna. Now I understand that you are you and me are one, and I am the witnessing consciousness, everything. I understand the three guna also, that I have to go beyond the waking dream and deep sleep, the three guna or the trigunatmika prakriti. But then why am I not able to be steady there? This was his question. If I understand, then why am I not able to abide? Why, after I come out, after even after understanding, why my experience of the world is still the same as before? Why is it still the same? So, if in that context, you understand what is being told here. Okay? Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om. Just sit still for half a minute. Hari Om.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.
Hari Om Swamiji.
Next class on Saturday.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.
Hari Om. Swamiji.
Ah, Lumina.
Hari Om Swamiji.
Ah, both. Catch you on Saturday. Bye. I'm checking out, okay?